Hello there, engineers, and welcome to this video for Prompt Geek. In this video, I'm going to be trying something a little different. I'm bringing to you a series now of regular videos where I'm going to be reviewing the latest models on Civit AI. For those searching for the secret to realistic AI images in Stable Diffusion, many have actually held off on the move from SD 1.5 to SDXL. But could this model be strong enough for even me to finally make the switch? The model we are looking at is RealViz XL V2. This came out just 6 days ago, and my goodness, the images look fantastic. One of the biggest problems with Stable Diffusion XL so far has been how plasticky people tend to look. But in this particular model, they do not look plasticky at all. In fact, we have got some fantastic grain in the images, some wrinkles and imperfections in the skin. The quality of the images coming out of this model are really astounding. And of course, with it being SDXL, we are looking at much higher resolutions as well. So in this video, I'm going to show you where to download it from, the link in the description down below, where to put it, and then, of course, the important bit, the settings you're going to need in order to be able to make this model put out the best images ever, and of course, some prompts for you to try out too. So let's get started. So the first thing to do is, of course, head over to civitai.com, and I've put the link in the description down below. It is a hefty file, and that is because it is an SDXL checkpoint, and they tend to be a little bit larger. Now, this particular checkpoint is the mixture of several different checkpoints. You can see here that it's Emerge of Dream Shaper, Juggernaut, SDVN6, and then a couple of other ones there as well. To install it, we just come along here to Download. Now, if you're using Focus, like I will be, you'll go to Focus. You'll go into the rig folder, down to Models and Checkpoints, and you will save it here. If you're not using Focus and you are still using Automatic 1111 for your SDXL generations, you will actually come through to your Stable Diffusion folder. You will go to Models, and then you will go to the Stable Diffusion folder to save it here. Either way, you're going to save it. It's going to take a few minutes because it is a massive file. You see, I've already downloaded this already. You'll notice, though, that this one does have a bay baked into it. So hit save, let it download. Then you want to start up Focus or Stable Diffusion, Automatic 1111, depending on which window you're using. Now that Focus is open, what we want to do is we want to make sure that we are going to use the right settings for this particular model. A lot of these models do have best practices, so let's just quickly check what they are. First of all, we do want to use the correct negative prompts in here. So we'll copy that negative prompt, come over to Focus, click Advanced. Then we're going to paste that here in the negative prompt section. You'll see that the recommended parameters are 15 to 30 steps using DPM++ SDE Keras. In Focus, with Advanced selected, we can do that by going to the Advanced tab, going down to Developer Debug Mode. We can change our sampler method by clicking on this and choosing DPM++ SDE, and scheduler will be Keras. We'll want to go to the Model tab. We want to change the base model here to RealViz XL V20. We don't need the vase. We can turn this refiner off. This Allura is automatically switched on. We can leave it on there. It's an offset, so it will mean that your images should have a little bit more contrast. And for this particular case, we'll leave all the other Auras empty as well. In terms of style, we can leave it on Focus V2 and on slightly cinematic if we prefer. And I think it would be better to have it in more of a portrait style, so I'm going to just change the aspect ratio to something like 896 by 1152. So with all the settings ready to go, we just need to get our prompt in here. So here's my prompt. High fashion photography photo of a young woman with detailed skin with platinum chignon hair, shot on Canon EOS 5D, and let's generate that image and see what result we get. Now, out of the box, these images do look nice. However, they do lack a little bit of that kind of realistic edge. You would certainly see the model is creating some texture on the face, but this does look a bit too polished. Now, part of that could be that I've actually said high fashion, and a lot of fashion photos are very airbrushed. However, there is also the point here that the actual sampling sharpness could be a little too low on here. So we can come into the Advanced tab. We can actually increase that. Let's put that up to 10. That actually take off the default style as well and see how that affects the image. We'll stick with the same prompt, but let's run that again. And you can see the result this time around is a lot more actually realistic looking. It still looks like a high fashion photograph. It's got that kind of polished look, but it certainly feels a lot more grounded and real than the last generation. And you could see that here in this image. You could see there you've got the actual skin textures and the individual strands of hair visible. So let's try that now with a different prompt. This one's a little bit more involved. It's a large format photo of a woman with a gaunt face with black short twin hair, wearing a top, headshot, edge lighting, high angle, Tri-X 400 film in the style of Nan Goldin. Now, if you're wondering how I do come up with these prompts and how I'm getting images that look realistic, the answer to that is available to all of you for free if you use the link in the description down below and go and download my free ebook called Creating Photorealistic Images with AI Using Stable Diffusion. It has 282 five-star ratings and over 10,000 downloads. It's 182 pages packed full of information about how you can prompt and get amazing results from Stable Diffusion that look incredibly realistic. All of that for the total price of $0. However, of course, if you do want to support the channel and want to support me, then please do go ahead and donate a couple of dollars towards my coffee fund, which is always welcome because I need that coffee to stay awake. I am working on a new book for you as we speak. Go ahead, download it for free, and then get this model downloaded and tested out in SDXL. So going back to that, let's generate this next image. The result for this prompt is even more impressive, and you can just see here the level of detail and realism in those images. This one, of course, is the closest one to Tri-X 400 because it is a black and white film type, and it just looks great. You've got so much detail in the skin and in the grain of the image. If we have a look at these close up, maybe a little too much detail. It might be worth even just scaling back the sharpness on here a tad bit. But as you can see, we have got a great result. Let's run one more through here. We're going to be going with this prompt here. Modernist photo of a young woman with a cute face with brown victory rolls hairstyle, wearing a tailored jacket, close up on face, edge lighting, Dutch angle. We'd put weight to that. And shot on Eaton LTR black and white in the style of Lee Friedlander. The result, we've got our woman there with her victory roll hairstyle. You can see the Dutch angle playing out in their horizon behind her. It is, of course, black and white as well. And if we zoom in on this image, you can see that it has a huge amount of detail in the skin, in the textures of the clothing. We can, of course, then turn this into an input image to upscale, and we can just drag that down below, upscale it by 2 times, and then we will be able to get a much more high-res version of this image as well. After a few minutes, you then have a much higher resolution version of your image. I just opened this in a new tab. We've gone from 896 by 1152 to a whopping 1792 pixels by 2305. If we open it up and have a look, you can see that we have a much higher resolution image. We can really zoom in on this, and it is very high quality with huge amounts of detail in this image. I'm going to just do us one last image. A cross-processed photo of a young woman wearing makeup with black sleek ponytail hair, blue eyes, headshot, Canon EOS 5D. Let's give her actually something to wear as well, wearing a sequin jumpsuit. And we should order this correctly, so let's take the blue eyes because they're more important than the clothes, and we're going to put those here. Okay, and now we're ready to run this prompt, and let's see what we get. And the last one there followed the prompt really nicely. I would probably say that we can straight off tell that this eye is off. So if you wanted to fix that, you'd go to input image, you'd go to inpaint, you'd drag it in here. You would then paint over the eye, change a prompt to just a eye of blue pupil, and you'd render to fix that. We're not going to do that on this particular occasion because I am just doing this for an example. But as you can see, you can get some fantastic results with this model, like I said, using decent prompt structure, like the one I promote in my free book, Creating Photorealistic Images with Stable Diffusion. You too can create amazing lifelike images in Stable Diffusion XL. Now, if you liked this type of video, the review of the different models available on Civit AI, do let me know by hitting that like button and subscribing to the channel, and I'll make sure to bring out regular reviews. There's so many of them and they take up so much space on your hard drive. You can't waste all your time downloading them and testing them all out. Leave that for me and I will make sure I let you know what the best ones are out there every single week. So, as I said, make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time, prompt engineers.